life is a short trip. The music's for the sad man. Forever young, I wanna be forever young. Do you really want to live forever? Forever and ever. Forever young, I wanna be forever.
Hey, make the best of your today's, be the worst of your tomorrow's. We ain't even thinking that far. You know what I mean? So we living life like a video. Where the sun is always out and you never get old. And the champagne's always cold and the music's always good. And the pretty girls just happen to stop by in the hood. And they hop their pretty ass up on the hood of that pretty ass car without a wrinkle in today. Cause there's no tomorrow, just a picture perfect day that lasts a whole lifetime. And it never ends, cause all we have to do is hit rewind. Let's just stay in the moment, smoke some, drink some wine. Reminisce, talk some forever young. In your mind, leave them off the can erase, neither space nor time. So when the director yells cut, I'll be fine. Forever young,
forever young. I wanna be forever young. Do you really want to live forever? Forever young, I wanna be.
Fear not when, fear not why, fear not much while we're alive. Life is for living, I'm living a pie. See it somewhere up in the sky. Fear not die, I'll be alive for a million years. Bye-bye, so not for legend, I'm forever young. My name shall survive. Through the darkest blocks of a kitchen, souls of a pirate's pots. My name shall be passed down to generations while debating up in barbershops. Young, slung, hung here, shoulder it from here. With a little ambition, just what we can become here. And as the father passed the story down to his son's ears, younger kid, younger every year, yeah. So if you love me, baby, this is how you let me know. Don't ever let me go, that's how you let me know.
Baby, forever young, I wanna be forever young. Do you really want to live forever, forever and ever?
Popping up on Forbes, this gorgeous. Hold up. Daughter lost, they be talking. I be talking more, they nauseous. Hold up. I'll be here forever. You know I'm on my fourth. I ain't with foreclosure. I will never forfeit. Less than four bars. Google bring the chorus in. Did you get the picture yet? I'm painting you a portrait of young.
Yes, sir. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to be forever young and live forever. That's a beautiful song by my guy Jay. But this is another episode, Wind Down Wednesday edition of ENS Updates. Great space. I just got off of that Ron host with the ENS Maxis. Very positive energy, good vibes. Great space. So shout out to you, Ron, for taking initiative and setting that thing up. Before we even get deeper, it's another day in the lab. It's another day in the lab. Love it, hate it, whatever it is, we're here. We're here again as we approach the end of this year, right? We're here again as we approach the end of this year. I probably won't be doing a space on Friday as it's approaching the holiday times for me. So I know Christmas is on sometime this weekend. So might take... Well, not might. I'm going to take Friday off and enjoy time with my family and friends and things of that nature. So just a heads up right there. But with that being said, we could go ahead and get started with some news, right? And I think the biggest thing is I want to retouch what I touched on yesterday, just one segment of that, and that being the Visa news and Visa exploring automatic payments with Ethereum using blockchain technology. That is very bullish. And I think it went under the radar across ENS Twitter and across crypto Twitter. I think it went under the radar. They're literally exploring ways and actively finding solutions, if not already found a solution, where automatic payments could be done through all businesses. Imagine how many businesses interact and use the Visa software on a day-to-day basis. How many merchants are using Visa on a day-to-day basis? So what happens when Visa installs some type of mechanism incorporating the blockchain, Ethereum blockchain, to allow automatic payments directly from your ETH wallet to that business or whatever wallet it is? Because we know ENS interacts with hundreds of different currencies. That is huge news. So I also want you to take a step back and ask yourself, what are some things that I'm paying monthly back-to-back? Rent is one. If you have a Netflix account, is two, right? If you have a gym membership, that's three. So these are just simple things I just easily named off the top of my head that people are paying reoccurring monthly. Imagine if all that is on an ENS name and all that is on the Ethereum blockchain. That's what mass adoption has looked like. And these conversations are being had today, right now. They're being talked about right now today. They're being had today by big corporations, organizations, and they'll be implemented. They're being talked about, studied, researched, figured out, and they'll be implemented over the course of the next 12 to 36 months, in my opinion. So huge news, huge, huge, huge news. And that's a world I believe that we all envision. And I'm happy to know that Visa is being a visionary as well and trying to implement that and be the first movers. Cool. Next, breaking news. Users can purchase cryptocurrencies using debit cards, credit cards, and bank transfers on Uniswap. We need to see more of that. Shout out to Uniswap for making that happen. And one step easier for the average normie, we will want to say, to come in and get accustomed to crypto. This was pretty interesting news. This is a little older, but for 10K Club pretty much reached 40,000 ETH, 40K ETH in volume. That is pretty big. That would place them as 43rd ranked all time in total volume on OpenSea. And for 10K Club alone represents 53% of ENS total volume. So that's just that to me says a lot. You can't keep fading the digits if you are or you're looking past it. It represents more than half of all of ENS's volume, the 10K Club alone, right? So I think now's the opportunity where if you don't have one, don't rush and get one if you can't afford one. But pay attention to it. Pay attention to five digits. You know, they're going to follow the four digits as well. So if you can't get a 4D, get a 5D. It's not about the actual digits. It's about the percentage of change is going to go up in a bear market. So just keep that in mind. And last but not least, I thought this was really good news. Bear market stats. Vision had more sales volume than OpenSea past 24 hours. Good night, ENS. Is that not big news to y'all? That's big news to me that ENS Vision beat OpenSea in a 24-hour volume, the big conglomerate marketplace of OpenSea. Vision, in a 24-hour race, beat them. Now, what does this tell me? What does this tell me? This tells me that Vision is going to be potentially, I can't speak on behalf of them, but what I think on my behalf, is that Vision has the opportunity to be what OpenSea was in 2021 and 2024. The volume, the hype, the attention, the sales, the fees, the billions that they made in the PFP bull run that we all experienced, the NFT bull run we all experienced in 2021, I would not be not a tad bit surprised if Vision is anywhere, if bigger than that, past that, or around the same level as that, or maybe even a little smaller than that. It doesn't matter. I can't predict the future. But we're already talking about they're beating out OpenSea right now in the bear market. Imagine the bull market as all these integrations and things we're talking about with payments and adoption begins to manifest. So I definitely say we're in the right place, in my opinion, right place, right time. This is a last thing I'll say. This is a marathon. This is a marathon, and it's easy to get exhausted. It's easy to get exhausted if you try to run too fast. It's easy to get exhausted if you don't live your life as well. It's easy to get exhausted if you're only so focused on this and it's not happening quick enough for you, then you could tire yourself out. Take the weekends off sometimes, right? Have a drink. Spend time with your family. Sit back, kick your feet up, watch some movies, go on Netflix, do something, go to the gym. Also have another life, right? Also, you know, do other things to alleviate your mind from only ENS, from only crypto Twitter. Because the truth is, guys, it's not going to happen tomorrow. It's not going to happen next month. This is going to be something that happens over the course of years. That being said, enjoy your life and don't be so stuck on it. And then, you know, you're here every day, you're grinding every day. And then 8 months down the line, we're still in a similar situation, if not deeper in the bear market. And then you say, screw the whole thing. That's what I not want to happen. But anyway, that's my little rant for the day. I'm going to pass it on to our guy, RN1, a.k.a. the legend, the GOAT. Ron, the stage is yours, brother.
Hey, GM Kev, yeah. GM community. It's real. Burnout is real. It is. It's about pacing yourself, right? That's it. It's a marathon. It's a siege. It's a 10,000-mile death march. You've got to pace yourself, right? And because there's a lot to that, you know. There's a lot to that. There's a balance, you know. You got to have balance in life, and I'm probably not the one to be speaking about that. But even now, we can get a little out of balance, but don't get too far out of balance. Make sure that you drink more water, you exercise a little more, you eat better. My wife's had COVID now for a week, 8 days now, so. I've been, instead of eating good food with her, I've been eating out junk food. Like I literally ran out of places to eat. So I had to get on Google Maps and see. And then I found out there was a new Texas Roadhouse in town. So I had pretty good steak, or half a steak. I didn't eat the whole thing. I'm going to eat the rest of it later today. But yeah, you know, make sure you're, but I can tell I feel different because I haven't been eating. Normally I eat out every few days, but you know, when with my wife, she eats perfectly. So I'm eating salads and hummus and sprouted wheat bread. But I can feel the difference. So be sure to balance that, you know, and be sure to balance mentally. Set, part of it is just setting your expectations. Just say, you know what? I don't need that Lambo this year. I don't need that Rolex watch. I don't need that new car. I don't need, you know, give yourself a goal of 3 years down the road or something to accomplish those goals. If it happens earlier, great, but pace yourself for sure. And other thing I want to do is just want to shout out to all the good spaces. I see triple squirt gun, triple water gun, triple pistols, whatever he wants to be called. Flossen's going to come up, and I know he's got his space coming up tonight, him and Verse. Yeah, have that emoji space. Last night I was in the big year-end finale space with Queen Bee and Drowning, and a bunch of you were there, and Furion was there from ENS Visions, and it was a great space. And you know, ENS Latinos, we've got the other spaces going on. Just some really good space. Got the Wake and Bake show going on every morning at 8 a.m. Eastern time. So just a lot of good spaces going on, a lot of stuff to do. But once again, don't get, you know, you got to be productive too. I'm, because we're involved in a couple of new projects, I'm having to spend a lot more time, you know, organized, following a schedule. So I've been jumping on the spaces as kind of a way to, you know, other than this space, other than as a way to just kind of, you know, when I go down to grab a drink or run an errand or, you know, if I have something that I'm doing that I don't have to be, that I jump on those spaces. So they're good, but yeah, let's use this holiday as a way to kind of refresh and go into the new year invigorated, But, you know, it's growing. We've come a long way, you know. You know, with that big space last night, you know, Queen Bee saying, where will we be in a year? And same, where will we be at the end of 2023 with the ENS updates and all the projects we're working on and everything like that? And in regards to ENS Vision having three times the sales volume in ENS name that Open Seas did yesterday, we're very, very blessed to have our own little marketplace. I saw a couple of projects just get pulled off of through the whole Trump thing. There was all these derivative projects and people starting their own projects. A couple of them had good momentum, just got pulled. They didn't get rugged themselves, but they got pulled by Open Seas for whatever reason, good, bad, or indifferent. And they went to, you know, basically went to zero. You know, one project I saw went from $2.50 to $4 by the time they were let back on Open Seas. So maybe whatever Open Seas didn't like. Anyway, my point is we're good to have our own less restrictive, specific, you know, from the community, for the community, with the community, part of the community in ENS Vision. So we're blessed to have that. I hope they become a billion-dollar platform. I hope they overtake all those other guys who aren't focused on ENS and I don't even know that they do that much for the NFT communities, to be honest with you. Other than being the biggest and the first, I don't know that they really care and they're really striving to get better. So we're it's huge blessing for us to have them. And looking forward to the weekend, the holiday weekend, which is just another weekend for me. I'm not a big holiday guy, but I will take some time to relax a little bit. And I'm pretty excited to hear the updates from the one and only master about what's going on with the red letter project. So excited to hear that, Alpha, and excited to hear everything else the community has to say today.
Yep. Thank you, Ron. And again, great space earlier today, man. Good vibes for sure. So appreciate you for doing that. And let's pass the microphone over to the veteran himself, Master Dottie. The stage is yours, brother.
Good morning, guys. Yeah, so glad to be on this space again, because every day a good day, and we just had some big news, and I have just pinned the space on the top. And since today, redletter.is is born, and our first article, you know, on Mirror has been published. If you're interested, you can go ahead and click inside and take a look. And because I was I already spoke with Kev yesterday, I was talking to him, like, you know, when the day, you know, Red Letter launched, you know, services ready, and maybe I begged him to shrink his space from maybe 90 minutes to 60 minutes, so that for me I can take over the second hour and then do an AMA of Red Letter. So but today, earlier today, there's still some technical issues that the dev team is working on, so that the AMA will be, you know, tentatively arranged to be this time tomorrow, which means tomorrow Kev's space most probably will only take place for 60 minutes, and then we will host a separate AMA session to facilitate and introducing to you guys how to use it, because I want to get this launched before Christmas, 2 or 3 days before Christmas. And it's just the first feature, the first function we launch it right now is just a seasonal greeting card. We want to give everyone an opportunity to use the Red Letter service to mint an NFT as a, you know, seasonal greeting card to your friends, to the ones you love. And you know, it's just like how Red Letter is going to say hi to the whole world. So yeah, very excited about the whole thing, because we still got a lot of functionalities not choosing to get them launched as of today, because we want to take the step slow, and we want to see how everything goes, and we want to see the community's feedback. But Christmas, we just don't want to miss this one. Otherwise, we will take it very slow here. You know, everything has been tested and fully and without any issue. But I just personally want to get, this tool to everyone's hand to let you can use it. So yeah, very excited. And it's basically you can use our Red Letter service to mint mint a greeting card. So there's a template. You can write something, and you write the one the with the ENS address or the hash address, you know. And then an NFT shape of the card, EIC-1155, will be on the recipient's, you know, wallet, and they can check it, and you can pin, and you can copy paste the message and send on Twitter to check with him. Yeah, that's how it works. It's a very simple thing at the very beginning, but I believe it's a very meaningful thing. So you guys see, I have already pinned the first article of you know, Red Letter on top. Yeah, I would ask you guys, I would request you guys to help me to maybe click like or click retweet and follow Red Letter, because there will be a lot of the, you know, interesting, fun ways to play for us afterwards. For example, that subdomain, you know, claim. But right now, because we want to do everything before Christmas, let you guys have an opportunity to mint the Christmas card or seasonal greeting card, you know, other cards, so that a subdomain claim, we don't put it at the first batch, okay? And at the meantime, you know, we are still figuring out a lot of things on IPFS. So right now, we will be providing a URL, but not redletter.eth.limo at the very first stage. And we will put that decentralized way, you know, migrated over maybe after the second or third function moving on. But rest assured, this is the I think the very safe and secured contract that we have been working with in the past. So that we will provide more information in the next few hours regarding the URL. And you just need to have a wallet. You just need to have a MetaMask to log in with a wallet and write, you know, the recipient address. And then, you know, just send a card. That's all what it does for now. And I believe that's something good enough. If you guys, you know, it's just about the mood of Christmas. It's just about the mood of sending your love to the ones, maybe your friends, your families, your relatives, everyone. So, yeah, I have already screenshot, you know, on this space. Maybe the first batch, second batch, I will send to every single one. It's that right now in this space and card, so that yeah, and this time tomorrow after Kev's space, we will also host another AMA, just in case you guys have any questions and uncertainties, we will facilitate and clarify all those during tomorrow's meeting. So yeah, I think every little step, it looks like it's a very normal and a very simple function or whatever. But, you know, it's really, you know, feeling exciting if we move the position from the ENS investor, from the domain player, over to a builder and build something that we believe makes sense for the whole community. And even the function is small. Sometimes the smaller, the bit better, right? So, yeah, I believe if everyone of the ENS community will have such a red letter or have such multiple of the red letter, you know, cards in your 1155 record, I think that's something proud for the whole community, not only for Red Letter. So yeah, I think that's the spirit why we are here, why we have been consistently here for the past six, seven months. Not because we have those great names, it's valuable, we can be rich, not only because of that, but because of why these names will be expensive, why we will be rich, because these are the great thing. These are the trend. These are whatever it takes to replace the .com. These are what is, you know, going to beat the traditional internet. We know this is going to happen. And Red Letter is just creating such a platform, such an environment for you guys to put something we say forever in the world, because there's no forever in Web 2. Right, the Web 2 structure is that it has a TLD domain name which can be banned. That domain name associated to an IP address, which is from the ISP, which also can be banned. And that IP address come to a web server or database server or AWS something, which also can be banned. And the server itself, the service, and the plug can be pulled. Every part is vulnerable. From my perspective, but Web3, look at the Red Letter service in long run. You know, at the beginning, it's an ENS name, which is on a protocol on smart contract, and you cannot remove it. And as long as I renew the domain for 1,000 years, okay, then it will be on for 1,000 years. IPFS, the file, the web content file on IPFS. So this is something permanent, right? This is decentralized firing system. And also the smart contract, you know, to settle the dynamic part, which is also decentralized. So nothing is vulnerable. So that's why we are here. That's why this is a trend. That's why every time we talk about these stories, we are so bullish and so exciting. And something within our eye will shine, or so something special to people when they look to us. And yeah, I think that's the spirit for us to stay close, staying together to do this. So I'm unfortunately sorry, I cannot disclose too much details as of now, because you know, I must wait here the dev have everything ready, and I test one last round maybe after next couple hours. Then I will just we will just publish another space and publish another Twitter and announce the details. And in most cases, 99.99% that tomorrow we will tomorrow right after Kev's space, we will take over. We will, there will be an AMA from Red Letter, and I encourage, I hope, I request majority of you can be there to show support, and I hope you guys can help me to retweet. This is the time I really need some of the, you know, the support from the community, given the past six, seven months, and I think we've been all here. And finally, you've seen some damn, you know, domain squatter doing something kind of interesting. I think that might be something, you know, valuable or meaningful. We say if we keep doing one thing and we keep seeing one guy's, you know, acting like one way. Yeah, that's from my deep heart. And thanks so much for you guys. And I look forward to launch a perfect product. Although at the beginning, it's just a very simple thing. But I believe in the long run, this can be something special for all of you. Thank you so much.
Yes, sir. Master, we will be there, right? We will all be in attendance. Well, I can't speak for everybody, but I certainly will be there. I just retweeted the pinned tweet you have on top, and I follow the redletter.eth page as well. And I encourage everybody in this room to do the same. Let's show some love. Let's show some support for somebody who's been around this community from day one, literally from basically day one, and who's been supporting this space for a very long time. So proud of you, Master. I look forward to seeing the release and the AMA and all that other good stuff as well. So with that being said, I want to give a huge shout out to our sponsor, vpn.eth.limo. They're the ones that make this space possible each and every day with the best content in all of Web3 and all of ENS Twitter. And a special word from them. Are you tired of feeling vulnerable and exposed online? Do you worry about your personal data being tracked and collected without your consent? With vpn.eth.limo, you can take control of your online privacy and security. Our easy-to-use website allows you to compare the best VPN providers and features, so you can choose the right one for you. A VPN will protect your location, hide your IP address, and encrypt your internet traffic, ensuring that your personal data stays private. Don't wait any longer. Take back your online security. Visit vpn.eth.limo now and sign up for a VPN today. Protect yourself and your loved ones from the prying eyes of hackers and cyber criminals. Sign up today and enjoy the peace of mind. With that being said, y'all, we have about 60 people in this room and only 14 retweets. So I ask that you guys go ahead, and I'm going to pin it to the top. Please just go ahead and give this room a retweet. That would be very much appreciated. I'm going to pass the mic right over to our guy, NFT Verse. The stage is yours, brother.
GM 5159. Always appreciate you, bro. Thanks for continuing to stay consistent out here, man. 8 months, about to be 9 months in at some point, right? So I continue to look forward to the 1 year anniversary, you know, when we do reach that particular milestone. So definitely looking forward to that. So shout out to you as always. Shout out to RM1.eth. Ron, I wasn't able to make it to that space this morning, but I don't know if you recorded it or not, but I'll definitely
try. No, I didn't record it. I was talking to myself for the first 8 minutes. I didn't have a good service. So anyway, we didn't record. I don't know if we're even going to, but yeah.
Okay.
No, stop by anytime. It's just, Kev was there and a bunch of people stopped by. It was a great first space. And once again, man, it sure is easier to listen or speak or co-host than it is to host. Shout out to Kevin, man. Been getting this done for 8 months. So all the pressure. No, look, we're happy to co-host and help. There's zero pressure on the co-host. 100% of the pressure's on the host. So, man, not as easy as it looks. It really isn't.
So true, so true, man. But yeah, is that a every day space going forward, like a Monday through Friday?
Yeah, we're going 7 days a week. It's going to be me, Ficker, and Bama, ACV, you know, for Bama.eth and Ficker.eth. And we're going to do it 7 days a week. And I don't know if I'll be tweeting it out every day or if we'll be switching off the host. But yeah, we're going to go 7 days a week. So I think some days it'll be coming from Ficker or Bama.eth. But yeah, no, the plan is just to have a solid every day we can plan on it, up and down. You know, I rug it at 9 to 11 a.m. no matter what. And so it's just up and down teaching people about Maxis. You know, it's a green space because you know how a lot of those, a lot of fun in those other spaces, but you get slapped around a little sometimes. And so for the newer people, we're not, you know, shills, just shills. We're not that nice, but we do the best we can. And yeah, so, and today we answered a few ENS questions. So yeah, just really trying to get new people as much as possible. So yeah, a lot of people came though and showed us support.
I think that's a good thing. I think that, you know, finding balance out there, right? You know, there's so many spaces out there that we have, but, you know, having that maxi space and then, you know, having that, you know, having the structure to say, hey, this is for, you know, talking about ENS, the Maxis, but also onboarding too. So I think that that's a good balance, Ron. So definitely appreciate you guys taking on that, man. Shout out to Master, man. Master, Red Letter, man. Excited about that for you, man. The Christmas greeting cards being the first phase. That's pretty cool. Can't wait to see that, man. Can't wait to hear more about that. For the AMA. I'm trying to get me some questions ready for you, Master, for the AMA. So definitely looking forward to that. Shout out to Mr. 618 in here, Steve. Steven Miller, my guy. That's Dr. Boob. I know that's Dr. Boob in there. What's up, man? I hope everything's going good. Crypto Reporter. Yeah, man. So just a couple of things I wanted to touch on. Shout out to the whole entire community, man. Again, thanks for tapping in. 00, I see you out there. Young SB, Drea, Enzo, man. I love seeing everybody continue to show up, man. If you haven't retweeted the space out, like Kev said, go ahead and retweet the space out, man. Get some more people in here. But first thing I want to talk about is, you know, just certain things that I notice, right? You know, when I usually go on the OpenSea, right? OpenSea has coined themselves the largest marketplace, right, for NFTs and, you know, whatever else that they have in that slogan. 00, I'm thinking that why haven't you guys coined yourself the largest Web3 domain marketplace, the largest ENS market? I mean, there's something to say about being the largest, and I think that you guys have proven yourself and have the data to back it up to say that you are the largest something. You know, when it comes to ENS, as far as a marketplace, man, I think that's definitely something maybe you guys can incorporate somewhere in that slogan when you go to your website, because I think it's well earned. I think it's been proven. And I think that you can use that terminology in that particular, you know, to coin yourself that and put that on your website. That's what I believe. Okay. Whether or not anybody else does, or you guys are ready to kind of put that label on yourselves, I think it's due time and that you guys can do that. So I just want to call that out, first of all. Second, shout out to Queen B and Get Hype and I'm the Batman for the Mega Space. Last night I was on there and a whole bunch of other people in the community came up to speak. That was amazing. You know, Christmas, a lot of giveaways. You know, I was able to give away a drink bottle, you know, some Cigar Lounge NFT, you know, for some people in the community. So, man, they put it together very nicely. It was great to have so many people there in the community that tapped in. So I want to just give them a shout out for putting that all together and bringing people together for that mega space. So shout out to them. Second thing, man, there's so many other holiday spaces coming up. So I did post a few out there. I'm pretty sure there's some people in the audience may want to come up and plug the holiday spaces out there, man. It's, you know, golly, man. It's so nice to be able to see where we came from, you know, so many months back to, man, everything just being jam-packed, crowded. I mean, Stephen Miller just put out a new calendar, and that's just for Monday through Friday. He hadn't even incorporated the weekend yet in the calendar. And Stephen, shout out to you, man, for putting that calendar together, man. It looks great. I love it. I love to have the visual of what's going on. I even tagged the ENS Dow and the other ENS account in that particular response to you, Stephen, your calendar. So I made sure I tagged them in there because, I mean, that's an amazing visual to see the activity that's going on in the community. And if they ever wanted to have one of their community stewards or anybody tap in, they have it right there in front of them. They have the calendar right there. They can tap into whichever one they decide that they want to plug into, man. So that's very important for the community. So I definitely appreciate you putting that out there. The next thing was the visa thing. Kev had touched on really quick. Guys, Visa is not dumb, okay? Why wouldn't they come into this space and offer their credit cards that actually have an interest rate on them and finance charges? You think they're not going to make any money, you know, selling, you know, the convenience of being able to purchase things with the credit card and then, you know, mentioning the Ethereum blockchain? They're providing a level of convenience for everybody out there who's starting to move into Web3 and crypto and NFTs. That makes sense. It just totally makes sense. But understand this, and not financial advice, but always understand that when you're utilizing those methods of payment, that you have an interest rate on your credit card and you're going to be charged that as that balance carries over from month to month. So just know that, hey, you're not just purchasing something wham, bam, and this, you don't have an interest rate on it. You're going to continue to pay interest rate and finance charges on that as it carries over. So that's just a money management lesson to just be aware of your situation from a financial perspective. And if you are using a Visa card or something like that, just like anything else that you purchase in real life or whatever, right? They're moving over here to provide that convenience. And by them moving over here into this particular avenue or industry, I think it's still bullish, right? It's still bullish on how they're moving over because they're seeing the activity. But like I said from the beginning, wherever the money is, the big boys will come. You don't have to persuade them. They will come when they see commerce occurring and commerce happening at a huge level. They're all going to come in. It's just a matter of time. And if we can continue to position ourselves correctly, right, as more and more people start to hear that narrative of blockchain, Ethereum, Bitcoin, and transactions and cheap transaction and cutting out the middleman and all of this stuff and convenience, more people are going to start to come over. And like I said, I look forward, and I said this before, I look forward to the Super Bowl commercials, right? I mean, as crypto continues to be that narrative right out there. It was just a tease last year with the whole crypto.com and the Bored Ape, but so much has happened since then. Who's going to stand out and be in the forefront of the Super Bowl commercials and have all eyes on them? Who's willing to step up as a company and that's crypto friendly to say, hey, we know everything that went on, but we're still going to pave the way. It's going to be interesting to see what happens with that. But I'm not going to keep going on. I got all kind of stuff I had written down, but I'm not going to go through all that. I appreciate everybody tapping in, man. This is what this space is all about, building. It's an open forum. Come up, introduce yourself, talk about what you got going on, man. We'd love to hear from you. I appreciate you, Kev, as always. Yeah, I'll go ahead and I'll hand it back to you, Kev. Thanks, everybody.
Nah, bro. Please, you could have went on if you wanted to go on, right? I think you were dropping gems, you were dropping alpha, you were dropping knowledge. But all good, all good. I know you have to run in a little bit, but like I said, always appreciate you, Verge, for coming on and supporting the show and giving back to the community. That matters, and it doesn't go unnoticed, not one bit. Cool. We'll keep it moving right along. Let's go over to our guy, Stephen Miller, a.k.a. The Shark. The stage is yours, brother.
GM Kev, Ron, Master, the whole damn fam. Good to see you all this morning. Do want to give a quick tip of the cap to Ron, man. You got a great space this morning. Glad to see that you're kicking it off in the right way. And honestly, it's what we need. We need more positive spaces as much as people want to say that we can get a little bit too virtue signally over here. You can have a good space without virtue signaling. You can do good. You can onboard. You can help people understand shit better. You know, that's what these green spaces are about. So big tip of the cap to you, man. Verse back onto what you said about vision, the initial pitch at the beginning, the most like the biggest marketplace for Web3 domains out there. That type of byline is huge because, again, what is a vision without the buy-in of a community? And having a community want to spread that vision. So I'm all for it, man. I hope that, you know, they adopt something like that. The one thing I did want to say this morning is some of you heard I did, in fact, drop a new version of the calendar. But the calendar that I put out was really just a teaser. So I want to make sure that that disclaimer is out there and people understand that, you know, what was dropped last night was just a look at what's to come. I wanted to come up this morning really just to ask everybody if you do have a space that you're consistently operating, right? It's something that's been out for 2 to 3 weeks. You're operating it at a consistent time slot on a certain day of the week. Drop me a DM. I've got a lot of them already logged, but I need to, you know, continue to iterate and update the calendar. We've got the weekend version will be coming soon. I wanted to start with the 5 days a week because, again, when you're trying to make it a full calendar, like, you would be shocked at what goes into trying to make sure that everything maps properly and that it lays out right. So I wanted to make sure that we separated out the weekdays from the weekend, so that it will have its own dedicated calendar. That way, you know, we can give some love to Saturday and everybody else who has a weekend space, like the, you know, Sunday morning NFL ENS show that Flexter runs. So, yeah, there's a lot of exciting stuff going on, guys. Please, please do me a solid. Drop me a DM if you want to be featured on the calendar. And honestly, if you've seen the graphic and you have feedback, like, I'm all ears. I love iterating and experimenting with what I design. So if you have, you know, some advice that you'd like to impart, drop me a DM as well. I'd be happy to connect. So that's all I really got this morning, Kev. But I hope you guys all have a great Wednesday. And if you have a minute tonight, go check out Minting Coins for that that Whiskey Wednesdays. That's a ruckus show, man. I think Gary nearly put me under the table last week. Cheers.
Hey, that's hilarious. Cheers to Stephen Miller, a.k.a. The Shark. I look forward to season 2 of The Shark Tank coming out in 2023, so you guys keep your ears and your eyes open. For that one, Steve, thank you for coming on stage and showing us some love, brother. Let's go right over to Crypto Reporter, our guy. The stage is yours, man.
Hey, everybody. GM. Sun is shining, grass is green, as Gary would say. Shout out Gary, man. Definitely a visionary in the space. Shout out you, Kev, as well. Always. Like NFT first said, you know, it's been 8 months now. Like, that's dedication. That's how you know we're going somewhere. Good morning to the co-host. We got Ron, NFT Verse. Master, I'm excited to see what you do with Red Letter Man. I got goosebumps, you know, just based off the conversations that we've had. I really think you have something here. And so it's going to be great to see that. What's going on, Thread? Stephen Miller, Zero, Drea. God, I got to get some of these Santa Claus hats because I see you and Magnum. Between you both at the Santa Claus sides, I feel left out, man. I need that. But anyways, real quickly, guys, because I don't want to take up too much of the show, but I did want to say that there are a lot of things that are coming down the pipeline. We had that amazing thing with MetaMask and PayPal last week, and we all know that if this were a bull market, that would have just set it off. It's crazy to see the things that are happening in the bear, the building, the collaboration, the networking in the bear. And I think that's just going to manifest more fully in the bull market. So excited for that. I recently did an interview with I'm not sure if you guys know, but there is this politician by the name of UtahPolitician.eth, also known as January Walker. And so around sometime last week, we were able to do an interview with her, and she was able to have some pretty amazing points when it came to just self-sovereignty, digital identity, just so many different things that she was, you know, talking about. And it took me back because, honestly, she was one of the very first interviews I've had alongside with Gary, and just learning, you know, the things that she's been through, the different journeys, the, you know, surveillance and all these different aspects, it brought me back to really when I, you know, first started in this whole community. It brought me back to, you know, just trying different things with Gary, as far as with Web3 domains. Brought me back to the times being able to work with Master for Red Letter. Brought me back to the time working with Sean Murray with ETH.Photos. And I had realized in that moment that, you know, this was all preparation for the next thing. Every time that I was, you know, helping out or assisting, I really thought of it as preparation for the next thing to come. And so I'm excited to share with you guys that today I feel as though it's all finally come together, because I woke up this morning and I was waiting anxiously for the past couple of weeks now to see whether it would be approved or not. But safe to say now that I will be speaking at NFT NYC 2023. So I'm highly excited. I'm super excited for that. And honestly, guys, when I tell you, I'm at a loss for words, really, about how I feel, because it wasn't long. It didn't feel long, but I just remember trying to help out, trying to do things within the space so that I could prepare myself for the next thing and to be able to learn and network with this community. Oh my gosh. It was a blessing. It had to be. So yeah, I got a slot for sometime in, I think it's April, for NFT NYC. So if you guys want to meet, you know, I'll be there. Hopefully, you know, networking, just talking to you guys. And because, yeah, man, it's just a whole experience. And I think that all of these different things that we were working on, talking with different people about, has prepared me finally to talk about digital identity at that next conference. So just wanted to say, you know, thank you guys. I appreciate you guys so much. And I think I said this before, but I'll say it again, which is, you know, Web3, ENS in particular, definitely changed my life. It changed the trajectory. And so once again, have to say thank you, but I'll get off the stage now. I appreciate every single one of you. Love you all. Peace.
Go ahead, Verse.
This actually means that Crypto Reporter's new slogan must be "From the Closet to the Stage." Amazing Crypto Reporter. I love it, funny. Bro.
You're funny for that. Well, you know the crazy thing is, because I jumped into the last one. I jumped into the last Friday night happy hour for a little bit, and every time I'm there, man, even if I'm not there, sometimes I'll catch the recordings. You guys are hilarious. And so I just think about just all the different projects that are happening in the community, all the things I'm still missing out on, really, because there are so many spaces. But that just shows that the network, what we're building here, is growing. And it's amazing to see. But yeah, thank you, NFT Verse, man. Yeah, from the closet out into the stage. We'll take that.
Amazing,
we'll take
amazing, man. Keep up the good work, bro. You're doing some big things out here, man. Amazing. I can't wait for that to occur, man, and happen, man. And you've been in the trenches. You've been doing your due diligence, man. You've been out here working, man. So, man, I tell you, being rewarded like that and having that opportunity, you know, I'm speechless, man. Congrats, man.
Report. Huge congratulations as well, brother, from myself. That is huge. And I know you're going to crush it. You're going to kill it, right? Coming on spaces, speaking on spaces day in and day out, doing interviews, podcasts, so forth and so on. It has all prepared you for that moment. And we'll be there to support you for sure when that time certainly arrives.
Thank you, guys. Also wanted to say the whole point of the conference at the event, I want to be highlighting different things that are happening within the ENS community. So, of course, they got to come to the ENS update show. They got to come to the Friday night happy hour. They got to come to Trading Post. Like, they got to know about the Maxi. So it's just, thank you, guys. I appreciate every single one of you, like I said. But all right, Kev, I'll give it back to you, Matt.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Keep up the good work, man. That's a huge win for the entire community right there. So that's a bomb. That's what we need. We need more people talking about digital identities. We need more people at these conferences, at these events. It's not just talking about these pump and dump projects, right? Let's go over to the lovely, the beautiful Thread Girl. The stage is yours. Welcome to ENS Updates.
Yo, guys, how's everyone? Kev, Ron, Master Zero, NFTverse, Floss, and Mr. 618, Steven, and Crypto Reporter. First of all, Crypto Reporter, I want to say big congratulations, man. This is huge news, insane news, like not just for you, but for the whole ENS community, right? We have someone from us repping what we talk about and really believe in and have our life savings and investments and, you know. And man, this literally brings me to what I wanted to say and why I requested to speak today. So that was an insane space last night. Felt legit like a Christmas party with the friends. And I was thinking, like, man, it was less than a year ago, we were here saying, bro, if you're here, you're gonna make it. If you're here, you're gonna do something and be something, because you're getting to know every single thing that is happening in the space. You're getting to know every single technology that's being built and getting to know the builders themselves, right? And this is like, it doesn't happen in any other industry. And yeah, man, and look at you now, Crypto Reporter, like doing this, man. So fucking just wanted to jump here to say, like, I'm so fucking grateful for all the ENS community and you guys and ENS updates. And bro, when we talk about, yeah, getting to know everything that's happening, that's because of your work, Kev, for real. Like, you're taking the time of your day to get all those news and to be able to pin them up top for us to see them, right? I can be not checking Twitter all day, and if I jump in here, I would know what's going on. So thank you for that. And just want to wish everyone happy holidays. Love you all. And yeah, thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Thread Girl. And don't forget to mention you're hosting a space tonight with Domain Plug. I will certainly be in attendance showing some love. Thread Girl hosts a great space every Wednesday. So I don't know why you didn't say that, but I'm going to shill it for you. And if you want to pin it to the top, Thread Girl, feel free to do that.
Guess what? So I was co-hosting a space 30 minutes ago. I DM'd Verse. He was on top of my list. Told him, please pin it up top. Then I told him, listen, fuck it, I'm leaving. Left the host alone to jump in here. But yeah, we're co-hosting a Domain Plug space tonight, 6 p.m. EST. It's gonna be epic. We got people who are not into in the ENS community per se, But they are big holders of ENS domains and huge people in Web3. So we're hoping for, like, if we talk more about ENS with them, they would wrap more ENS in their accounts and we would have more visibility in a sense. Plus, we have a guest speaker that you all love, okay? He's in the ENS community, never ever talked on a space before, and he said he's dropping by midway through the show. You guys all love him. He's like one of the funniest people in the space. But yeah, be there. We got surprises. It's a Christmas edition type of thing. Thank you.
All good. Appreciate you, Thread Girl, for all you do for this community. It doesn't go unnoticed, and you are a big role model to all of us. Let's go over to our guy, Zero, the founder of ZZC Group. Zero, the stage is yours, brother.
Hey, Kev, Ron, Master, NFTverse, Floss, Thread. Just wanted to give a couple updates. With the private grants, with the ENS Maxis and I, we've already distributed about 90% of the funds to the people that applied for the grant. We do have a few more to distribute, so that'll be probably by over the weekend. Two, ZZC Group, named Kevin, head of director of operations, so he's actually running the show. Three, ENS Vision. I'll give you a couple of stats, and I've already made this public, and you can also find it on Dune. Since opening the market in July, the 5-month stats, ENS Vision, through the ENS Vision website, you know, we do aggregate with other sites, so you can go to the Vision site, and you can actually purchase a name, you know, whether from LooksRare or OpenSea. So we've done over 100,000 sales transactions through our site, through the Vision site. Now, all of that is not obviously, you know, ENS Vision sales, but it's aggregated through our site. So it's 100,000 plus sales transactions, over 23,000 ETH transactions through the Vision site. A day and a half ago, we actually had more ENS sales transaction than OpenSea, which is the first time. Small win, but it's a win for ENS Vision. And another point, you know, all of this credit goes to, you know, LCFR, Zemetti, Furion, the real people that's behind the scenes building, and they're still not satisfied. And we're about actually 60% done building. There's a lot of back end still being built. And as soon as a name wrapper is out, we'll have a subdomain marketplace ready within a few days, but probably we'll open it up about a week after the wrapper's out, official wrapper's out. And it's not just a regular sub-market. You know how you go register your name? The root domain holder will have options. So there'll be options on how you actually can have someone mint your subdomain. So as well as two to three brand new innovation, because they're constantly innovating behind the scenes, not just putting up stuff, just to, you know, put stuff up on our site. So everything on our site has meaning, and there's a lot of features that are coming for 2023. So early 2023, you'll find a couple of brand new features, and as well as brand new innovations, which is, you know, something that obviously that's not haven't seen in the market or a marketplace. Another big, huge announcement coming from Vision is, you know, we have collabs with, I can't say with who, but it's a major firm where we're going to reach out to Web2 companies and Web2 people, bring them into Web3. So we're not just looking at Twitter and every other platform that we can possibly bring in. So there'll be a huge announcement, I think, within the first month or two in 2023. So we do appreciate all the kind words, this NFTverse and the community support. Let's not forget, you know, everyone the credit really goes to the devs and the founders of ENS Vision. Having said that, I am super excited to announce in early 2023, you'll see so many brand new features / clubs / category / tagging / enhanced filter. It's nonstop building. And like I said, 2 days ago, you know, we've had more ENS sales than about a day and a half than OS. And just if you think about it, 100,000 plus sales transactions through a startup since inception, which was the marketplace was open, I believe, in January. So if you do the 5 month stats, that's 20,000 sales transactions through Vision since inception. So we do appreciate, you know, the community support, and it's a pretty big number for a startup. And it's just actually the beginning. So the ENS Vision team, the core team, appreciates all the support and the community support and all the kind words. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Zero, for all you do for the community. Look forward to a lot of those updates and all that exciting news coming up. 2023 is going to be a great year for this community, right? A lot of updates, a lot of excitement, a lot of building going on here. So there's a lot to be excited for in a lot of different aspects, right? So I'm very excited for the year of 2023. All love. Appreciate you, Zero, for coming on stage and sharing that. And I'm pretty sure you'll have a lot more updates for us
over the course. Hey, can I just add one thing I forgot to add?
Yeah, please do.
When you're on the Vision site and you pick, let's say, you know, we give you options because we aggregate from other sites. If you pick an OS, let's say you go to Vision and you decide to buy from OS through Vision, there's no additional fee. You just pay the OS market fee. So Vision doesn't actually charge anything for you to go on Vision, pick another marketplace, and buy from that marketplace. We're just giving you the option, and we list it for you. We also list all the bids from all the other marketplaces that you received on your name.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Appreciate you, Zero, for sharing those updates. And I look forward to the rest of them over the course of the next several weeks and months. Let's go right over to our guy, Mr. 618. And then we'll go over to our guy, Flossin. And then we'll probably call it a day right after that.
Hello. Thanks for putting me up, Mr. 5159. So today I'm going to try to be concise because I love like how all the speakers are talking in this space. And I want to respect that space and involve also in that space. So good morning, everybody. Master, congratulations on that red letter. It was really great to connect to the red letter that if. And also like when I connected to it, actually redirected me to my wallet to connect with Optimist Network, which is a layer 2 solution. And I love Optimist Network for the fees, the low fees and stuff like that. So if you guys are in space, want to take a look at what is Optimism, feel free to take a look at what is Optimism Network. And I think I collect like one letter and subscribed to the channel. So it was good on that. Trade Girl, I love your introduction, the way you come on stage. It was like really flawlessly. And basically, I'm also going to try to keep organizing the way I'm speaking on space. So I tied like basically up there, like the Forex Trader, basically because Mixer 618, I'll try to basically do chart analysis. And in this space, ENS Update, we spoke a lot about AI and how also we can basically help evolving the space. So I've been using like a platform, AI platform called Syndicator. So when I'm going to come like further down on the line, I'm going to pin the tweet of like the address of Syndicator. But basically, Syndicator is a platform where you can have like forecast of where the market is going and give you like question for the sentiment analysis of different cryptocurrency or traditional markets. So for example, like this morning, there was a question about the Matic network, and it was saying like Matic network set up today at 79 cents and at 10 a.m. in the Binance exchange. And he asked you the question, will Matic network will trade at 87 cents before it goes to 71 cents. So by answering like this type of question, you know that there is two price that the token can go, and you can basically like forecast. And if you forecast like positively and you have like a positive balance at the end of the month, you get a little bit reward for your analysis, because like this powering like kind of the AI. So there is basically different questions. There is a question about Bitcoin and dominance and stuff like that. So for the Matic network, I answered like the answer positively, that it would go to 87 cents before it goes to 71 cents. And I'm not sure if I'm going to be right. I can be wrong, but you know, this is my analysis. And when I was on this platform, I made like about like 1,046 prediction with 61% accuracy. And basically that's helping me like advancing into my trading strategy, so people can basically use their, you know, forecast to position themselves on the market. So I'm not gonna stay too long. I wanna congratulate everybody. 5159, thank you for bringing the bombs back, especially for Crypto Reporter. Congratulations on being on stage on NFT NYC. I don't see him anymore, so probably he left. But yeah, I haven't heard the bomb for a long time. So thanks for bringing the bombs back. And yeah, have a good day, everybody.
Thank you. And you deserve a bomb as well, brother. So all good. Thank you for coming up and sharing that. And I would say this, being a speaker on stage, bro, this stage is open to everybody, right? And for some, speaking publicly, which is basically speaking publicly, comes more natural than others, and that's perfectly fine. But it's also a thing of the more you speak on stage, the better you become at it, the more natural it is for you, the more you improve, the more confidence you get in yourself. It's a lot. So Mr. 618, I think that's great self-awareness of you to say, okay, I like the way these other people are speaking, so I'm kind of going to adjust the way I speak. That is great self-awareness and a great improvement on how you speak on stages when you go on stages. It's a learning experience for all of us, right? It's not something that that comes natural unless you do it every single day. But cool. Appreciate you, brother. Let's go to our guy, Artie. Artie, the stage is yours, man. How you doing today? Oh, wait. Oh, never mind. Yeah, it's all, you're good. You're good, Ari. Floss and drop down. Stage is yours.
Well, thank you, Kev. Thank you very much for letting me come up. You know, I've got like, I want to say hi to everybody. Merry Christmas and all that. You know, I love you guys. But I've got like three or four people here in this town that I can count on my hand, that I can count on if I call them. And you guys are like my family. So I just want to tell all you guys that my daughter had a little baby today, and it was 5 pounds and 15 ounces. And she toughed it out pretty much all night at home. Got to the hospital. She was 9 centimeters, and she had it in about 30 minutes after she got there. So she did good. Everybody's healthy and happy. And I just wanted to share it with you guys, because I spend a lot of time with you guys, and I get a lot of love from you guys. And it was just great news. So hope everybody has a Merry Christmas. That's about it, Kev. I don't have any alpha.
Yes, sir. Congrats to the newest edition of your family, the ENS baby. We love all ENS babies already. So, you know, there's been a couple of ENS babies in the community. But, yeah, congrats, man. That is huge news. Shout out to you. Wishing the baby a lot of love, health, wealth, and abundance, man. And I'm going to send you the NFT. Thank you for it. Please send me a DM so I could remember to send that when gas is a bit lower, brother. Appreciate you coming on. Cool. Yeah, thank you. Thank you, bro. Let's go to my guy, Floss. And Floss, the stage is yours, bro.
Yo, GM, GM. Hey, I'm probably about to rug. If you haven't noticed, I've been rugging all morning. I gave a little warning about this at the Enos Latinos this morning. So I'll make it quick, man. Hey, great space, dude. This is like a mega space today, right? We got Master up here, U-verse, Thread Girl, 00, Stephen Miller. Who else is up here? Mr. 618. I'm driving, so I don't really know who else I left off. But, yeah, shout out to everyone who pulled up this morning. Lots of good spaces happening, too. I think, RN1 is going to start doing an ENS Maxi space before your space, Kev. So, like seeing all these new spaces popping up, especially, like, you know, I mean, I respect all spaces, but definitely need more good vibes like what Ron's going to be doing with Bama.E. So I'm looking forward to that in the mornings. Some interesting sales, too, recently, right? Like the three-letter sales. Like I saw who.e sold yesterday for like 4 ETH. I mean, that shit's cheap as hell. So seeing some good sales, right? And shout out ENS Vision. I mean, I think we take that that site for granted, right? It's really been a game changer, and it's really gave, I would say, freedom back to ENSers, right? Because obviously OpenSea doesn't care about us, X2Y2 doesn't. So it's just nice seeing people, you know, care about us. You know, same thing with Domain Plug. I know they're building and whatnot. So just good to see community, you know, people within the community looking out for one another. So shout out to ENS Vision and all what they're doing. Can't wait to hear more about what they have going on in 2023 for us. And let me say this, the feature I like the most so far is updating now with transactions showing our primary addresses, right? I mean, for me, seeing the triple water gun on there, Weston.eth, I mean, just it's different. So shout out 00 to you and your team on implementing that. So, but also space tonight, right? Emoji Pill space tonight. We got our guy CK the Ghost.eth pulling up. Going to be talking about his Web2 company that also has their ENS called Swampwater Frog Emoji.e. So looking forward to hearing what they have going with the real life beer product. Maybe we can, you know, get some type of deal sparked up with ENS Happy Hour, right? ENS Friday Night Happy Hour. We'll see. But yeah, no. Hey, Kev, thanks for everything, man. I'm going to shut up before I get rugged some more. with that being said, hey, real quick. Ace, tomorrow for the red letter?
Yep, tomorrow's red letter at 12 o'clock p.m. Eastern time.
Shout out to Master and Red Letter, right? Like, I'm looking forward to that. I'll definitely have service for that, so I'll be there.
Yes, sir. Appreciate you, brother. I just want to let you know you was rugging this entire time, but we caught the gist of everything you were saying. Appreciate you coming on stage and showing some love, man. Let's go over to our guy. Oh yeah, and the emoji spaces tonight. Y'all give, you don't follow Flossin, give Flossin a follow. He's doing an emoji space tonight. I'll definitely come up and tap into that. Verse, go ahead, bro.
Yeah, so Kev, I was thinking, since we got Flossin and we have Thread Girl here, and they actually, you know, got engaged on chain, you know, a while back ago. Maybe the red letter can make that official this time around. I don't know. I'm just throwing it out there, guys. It's up to you to make that decision, but, you know.
Go ahead, Floss.
Want to get into emotional stuff on ENS updates. You know, this still hurts me a lot. So I'm not going to get into it right now, but I doubt it first. I doubt it. What he did was unforgivable.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to open up that wound. I'm sorry. My bad.
Go open the wound and put salt on it, and then he's saying he's sorry.
Flossin, go ahead, bro.
I mean, I think I'm getting rejected right now, but that's all right, man. I mean, 'tis the season, right? But I was going to say, if Thread Girl pulled up tonight for the emoji space, I do have a present for her. Either I can gift it now, or I'll gift it on the live on... Verse knows what it is, too. Verse is the only one...
All right, he's done. He got rugged, unfortunately. So that means, Thread Girl, you have to pull up to his space tonight if you want to know what the little surprise that he has is. All good, all good. as we approach the ending of the show, let's go over to my guy, Enzo305. The stage is yours, brother. Thank you for joining
us. Good morning, everybody. 5159, Master, Zero, NFTverse, everyone in attendance, man. I want to say happy holidays to everyone. We continue to do this every day, show up regardless. I just had a quick question for Zero. Last night, I was up late at night talking to some veterans and friends that I've made over the last 20 plus years. And there's, you know, there's probably about 50 to 60,000 people in that group. And as I think about the subdomain, I want to be able to offer the opportunity to, you know, a lot of these veterans to go out and mint out their subdomain to armyretired.eth and retiredarmy.eth. I have both of those. And also armydd214.eth. Every soldier that transitions from the Army gets one of those, right? DD214 is pretty much your resume, leaving the Army, everything you did and your records. And a lot of them probably, you know, want that. So I had a question for Zero in regards to that. Once I lock my domain in ENS Vision, will they be able to directly go there and mint that out, and the fuse will automatically be burned, or do I have to do anything on my end, or everything will be taken care of as far as the minting process, and then they own full rights to that as long as my domain, of course, is extended out, you know, for years and I maintain it. That was pretty much the only question I had, Zero. Thanks.
So let me try to answer that. Our subdomain marketplace is already up and ready to go. It's already been built out. When you as the root domain owner will have the option. So when a user comes into the site and goes to retiredarmy.eth, right? That name the owner has an option to put it up for subdomains or not be able to mint subdomains. So on your end, you're going to have a couple of options. It's not just like, you know, you put it up and someone just comes and mints it. The devs made it so the owner of the root domain will have actually a few options how this subdomain could be minted. And as far as fuses, yes, that will be another option that the root domain holder will have. So having said that, a lot of new details will come out early 2023. Like I said, the subdomain market's already been built out. We're just waiting for their name wrapper. And once the name wrapper comes out, we'll be doing a few tests. But the devs made it so where it gets a very simple task where you can put it up for sale to mint as a sub or not. And it'll give you the option. So it's pretty basic. And I can't give more information away, but early 2023, we can give more info. And as far as the Army veterans, and you can just DM me directly and see if I can help answer any more questions down the road, especially for something like that. That would be a great, whether you're doing for charity or not. But I think this is something great for the veterans that we can help the veterans out. All better.
Yeah, I appreciate it, Zero. Thanks a lot, man. And, you know, these people, they're not involved as we are every day. So they have some questions in regards to that. And, you know, I just wanted to be able to answer it in a way where they understand it's easy as possible to go there, have some Ethereum in their wallet, mint it out, and so on and so forth. But we'll touch bases again in the future. Thank you. Thanks again for answering the question, man. Have a good day and happy holidays.
Let me give you a quick example, which I can divulge. Now you'll be able to bulk register subdomains, right? Let's say you wanted to bulk register 100 subdomains. Now these subdomains, just like the bulk register feature, you can send it to a different wallet. You don't have to keep it in your wallet. Like, so if you mint it, you can send it to a different wallet. Let's say you want to mint a subdomain, right? You don't have to, just like our bulk feature, I mean bulk registration, you can send that to your cold wallet directly instead of your hot wallet. The subdomain marketplace will have a similar feature. So if you wanted to mint a sub for someone else, you can just mint it, put a different address, and ship it there. It'll save you on gas. It could be like a gift thing. You know, a lot of the features on ENS Vision, I think people don't realize on the bulk registration, you can actually gift that ENS name, just put a different address. And instead of going into your hot wallet, it can go to your cold wallet, or it can go to someone else's wallet. And it'll just save you a little bit of gas. And, you know, once the submarket comes out, you'll have similar features. So, I mean, as it comes out, we're going to still be building on top of it. But right now, we're pretty much ready.
Wow, that's awesome. It's good to hear that I can go ahead and, you know, lock in 100 at a time, or, you know, like you said, 20, mint out some grails, give it away as gifts. And you guys are offering different options to domain holders. That's awesome, man. I can't wait to hear more about it down the road. Thanks again. Appreciate you.
Cool. Great questions. Let's go over to our final speaker of the day. ENS Maverick, the stage is yours. Take us home, brother.
Hey, thanks so much, Kev. We'll bring it home here in just a quick word or two. My debut here on the morning show. I just absolutely appreciate all that you do, Kev, to promote and build the community and the work you put in, the consistency. So many great people here that have built and helped us grow this ENS community. I want to throw out a quick idea. This is really going to be for most people in this ENS community, your first holiday season with friends, family members, associates, whatever label you want to put on them. And we all go through the what do you do, or what have you been up to lately. It's a great time to spread a little love for the ENS community, help people get their ENS domain or a domain. Speaking of which, shout out to Artie. Congratulations on the baby and your family and in the ENS family. And what a great birthday or gift for a baby to gift that baby an ENS domain, right? So 'tis the season. Be generous with your giving. Enjoy this holiday season with friends and family members. And thanks for all each of you do to help promote and build our community. And let's finish this year strong and launch 2023 stronger than ever. So back to you, Kev. Thanks again for all you do.
Yes, sir. Appreciate you, ENS Maverick. Thank you for coming on stage and just sharing some love and positivity with us before we called it a day. Please send me your wallet, and I want to get that ENS speaker collectible to you ASAP. And if you have came on stage and you don't own the ENS speaker collectible, please just send me your wallet, and I'll send those in batches when gas is a reasonable price for me. With that being said, y'all, shout out to our sponsor, VPN.eth.limo, who make this show possible each and every day. If you haven't already checked out their site, please do. VPN.eth.limo in any browser in their webpage will pull up, or you could shop for a VPN. We know how important a VPN is in Web3 for security purposes. And even if you don't want to purchase a VPN, just check them out to see how we're beginning to push the bounds of ENS beyond just speculating and buying and holding, right? Also, check out zzcgroup.eth.limo. It's a webpage we just built last night. It explains what we do, who we are, and how the hell we're going to get it done, right? Extremely basic page, but like I said, we're pushing the limits of these domains that we have in our wallet, and we're beginning to build things on top of them. So those are two pages. Those are two call to actions I encourage you guys to do. It takes 5 minutes out of your day, if even, to check that out. VPN.eth.limo and zzcgroup.eth.limo to learn more about our asset management firm. That being said, Kev4King, aka 5159, is out, and I'm going to find something to eat, probably a pub sub. So peace out, y'all.